Now it's time for Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul.
Hi, Chris.
Well, hello, Paul.
How are you today?
I'm good, man. How are you?
I'm great. It's great to be back. I apologize to everyone that it was basically my fault for not being here.
What?
Well,
you're too hard on yourself.
2 weeks ago, I wasn't here because I'm a father, and so I wanted to have Father's Day.
Right.
It was my day.
Yeah, you're the dad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then I wanted, equally important, last Sunday, brunch. And I wanted it.
Yeah. Hey, and if you want it, you got to get it, dude.
Yeah, that's what I always
You're
say.
You're not going to be around forever.
What?
You got to grab it and growl, my friend.
Well, we'd like to start the show with a song that basically symbolizes, it's not necessarily even the last week, but the last couple weeks.
Oh.
And if you can see what I'm trying to get at on this song, I'd appreciate it, Chris.
Yeah, that's sort of the whole gist of this bit.
Yes.
Is you play a song. He's not told me what it was and why he connects it to the past week. I have to figure that out.
And it is Leslie Gore with You Don't Own Me on Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul.
Okay, let me give this one some thought. It's quite, those hairdos, they've never really come back that way, have they? Yeah. Well, maybe eventually us white males will let women come back to those hairstyles.
Yes. You know. Well, everything is coming back.
Everything is coming back around. Yeah.
Because this is the late 60s.
Uh-huh. Let's see. Don't tell me what to do. Don't tell me what to say. Okay. Like, when do men ever tell women what to do?
Right.
Or what not to do? Or what to say? Yeah, I'm thinking this comes back to Roe v. Wade.
Yes, and it's not, I know a lot of people think it's Roe v. Wade, like a guy. Hey, do you know
Your buddy Roe v.?
Roe v. Wade, yeah.
Dude, who's calling Roe v.? He's got to come out and meet us.
I got to admit, that was Bobby Dooley who thought that.
Oh, I didn't know that, okay.
But yes, recently.
Okay, I figured it out.
Recently, our increasingly less democratic country.
Yeah.
Has taken away a constitutional right of a woman's privacy.
Yeah.
So, wow.
Yeah. Yeah. I've been gobsmacked, flabbergasted, and I'm using those weird words because I don't know what the right word is to describe how I've felt about all of this. And I hear the arguments, Paul.
Do you?
Hey, look, nothing was taken away. We just gave it back to the states. That's all we did. I am, I don't know, conspiratorial minded enough to believe that most of the people who are behind this don't want it to stop at just pushing it back to the states. That's what frightens me, is where we're headed with contraception and gay marriage and absolutely no choice when it comes to abortion for folks nationwide. We're heading to Sharia law only with Christianity. And guess what? It's no different.
Yes.
None.
And it's not Christian either.
Oh, it's no.
Hey, we'll get your cord. Hey, that's not your cord.
What?
Okay. Yeah. Right. There was a little noise. But anyway, welcome to Past Week Next Week with Chris and Paul. That's Leslie Gore. You don't own me. Evidently, we do.
I'm Chris.
We own you. And I'm Paul.
Yep.
Okay. This is the show where we review the most important things of the past week and get you ready for next week. It's your one-stop podcast to keep you updated. It's a real week review. So listen to us. You won't need any other information outlet. That's our guarantee. Maybe Televita.
Okay. That could be one other outlet.
Right.
Maybe.
It's Sunday morning. You can watch us on Facebook Live or listening on KCTK Radio. You can join the program by calling or texting us at 913-735-0060. We welcome your participation.
We do.
Because we are very progressive employers.
Mm-hmm.
We have given the texter of the week off for 4th of July.
Yeah. Well, he loves America.
Yeah. And we're like, you can take the day off.
Yeah.
We're not paying him.
No.
That time. But you can give us a call at 913-735-0060 or check out the Facebook page. Coming up, we have weekly news quiz, pop culture update, an incredible special feature, headlines and predictions, and much, much more. So what's going on, Chris? Let's get back in that conversation. I think
something
has.
So right back to Roe v., huh?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, so it terrifies me, dude.
I'm going to tell you my take on it, Chris.
Okay.
And there's this with this issue, there's always been this, well, men shouldn't have an opinion on it. Mm-hmm. Well, yes, if you're telling someone else what to do. Okay? Uh-huh. We talked about that a few weeks ago, that the Republican Party wants to tell other people what to do.
Yeah.
I think that people should have a right to privacy. Okay? Mm-hmm. And a right to their own decisions.
Yeah.
And I think we've got too much into this. Well, I know why we did this, but we've got too much in this. Well, it's a hard decision. Let a woman make her decision. And stuff. Whenever we do that, I feel like we infantilize. What's the word? You make them like a child.
Like a, yeah. Infantilize.
Infantilize women.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a tough. You know what? I don't care why they make the decision. They mm-hmm. get to make the decision. Mm-hmm. That's where I am in it. And this would be completely different if my late father was here. He would yell at me and say, but that could become a person and all this stuff. Enough of the nonsense. Enough of your fairy book stuff. Fairy tale.
Wow, you're just going
fairy
right
tale
there.
Stuff. It's nonsense. A person gets to do what they want to do. Because here's the news flash that we have lived in the last 50 years and we believe and are trying even more to believe mm-hmm. and our daughters have helped us even more is here's the news flash. Women are people and they're equal.
What?
Yeah.
Stop it.
Yeah.
Stop it. We can take that out in post, right?
Right.
God.
You know
yeah.
what I mean?
Yeah. Yes.
And
I know what
so,
you mean.
And anyone that goes, well, it just needs to go back to the States. Mm-hmm. It needs to go back. Enough of that nonsense.
Yeah.
We have states so they could keep slavery and they could do what they want. Enough of that nonsense.
I know.
And we have fought a civil war that some things people can't do, the states can't do, and we need a federal government to say they can do them. We fought the bloodiest war that we ever had.
That we ever did have.
For this.
Yeah.
And it was political. They did it because they could do it. That's mm-hmm. why they overturned Roe versus Wade, because they could.
Yeah. And it's terrifying to me to think about the slippery slope that we are on with what other things are they going to take away.
Mm-hmm. Here's another thing I need to mention.
Yeah.
Chris, I'm sorry.
Okay.
I was in the, I don't remember exactly the thing because it was so innocuous.
Uh-huh.
That we passed the trigger thing when I was in the legislature.
Mm-hmm.
Well, they all voted for it. I voted against it. They're never going to overdo Roe v. Wade.
Yeah.
It's a symbolic vote so they can run back home and mm-hmm. act like they did something. So then Missouri becomes the first.
Oh, God.
You know.
Yeah. A.G. Schmidt comes in. And did you read about the 10-year-old girl in Ohio that had to be driven across state lines?
Yeah. Isn't that terrible?
Yes. It's awful.
It's awful.
It is. And then a good friend of the show, although I don't know that he's ever listened, Brian Morse.
Yes. Maybe that's why he's a good friend of the show.
Yeah. He posted something. I liked how he put it. It was a Jewish perspective on abortion. Yeah, but he said, I want to make it clear, it's just one perspective. There would be many Jewish perspectives, just like there's many Christians.
There's many Jewish people.
Yes.
I've heard.
Basically, this person said from their perspective as a Jew,
mm-hmm.
they don't believe that life begins until the first breath is taken once outside the mother.
Mm-hmm.
And guess where they derive that from?
Probably from the Bible.
Yes, from the Torah, from the Old Testament mm-hmm. is where they get that. So my point is, you can make a case so many different ways. What? Just let the person make the choice.
Yes.
Just let them make the choice. I really am afraid we're going to be the equivalent of, these Middle Eastern countries that are under Shia law and mm-hmm. becoming a theocracy. It's terrifying to me when I hear a member of the U.S. Congress say, this separation of church and state is bullshit. The church should be telling the state what to do. Like,
You know how such nonsense that is? And so juvenile?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
What church?
Right, yeah.
Because if you want to get it all together, the Catholics are going to band together and have, you know, they have their top-down message.
Yes.
Well, that's all. They were all Catholic on the Supreme Court.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay.
Yeah.
All right. I grew up Catholic. Maybe I'll just go with that. They get to tell you that's the church.
Yeah.
No, that isn't the church.
No.
Right?
No. It's the evangelical church that's the church.
Oh, this guy over here.
Yeah.
I mean,
it's the Mormon church. We're the
It's nonsense.
Yeah.
It's nonsense.
Yeah. We need to keep it completely out of government. Yeah.
And then I fight with someone on Facebook who's not a friend of the show.
Ooh.
Why didn't the Democrats have a law to put this in? Well, here's why, folks. They never had the numbers to do it.
Mm-hmm.
And I can tell you firsthand, when I was in the legislature, we had, I don't know, 25%, maybe a little bit more, of our caucus was pro-life.
Mm-hmm.
And there, even the folks that voted for Obamacare, they had a provision in there that they couldn't go for abortion. And there were several Democrats that voted for that. So wow. They never had enough votes when Obama had the majority. And mm-hmm. the very brief time he had supermajority in the Senate, they never had a majority on this issue.
Yeah.
And the discussion I was having on Facebook with someone was, well, they didn't happen because they didn't make it a priority. And I said, no, they didn't have the numbers, so it wasn't a priority. Then I thought, you know, maybe it's chicken or the egg. Maybe if they would have said it's a priority, they could have got the votes. But the point is, no one ever thought this sound reasoning of right to privacy would ever be overturned.
Yeah, right.
So, yes, I'm also frustrated with Democrat leaders who don't do more. But we've never been in a – since that time, we've never had a huge Democratic majority mm-hmm. for a substantial amount of time.
Yeah, and I've seen
– you know what I mean?
I've seen so many people on Twitter, their answer to someone complaining is – last I checked, Democrats have the White House, the
right.
Senate. No. Go screw. Go
right.
pound sand.
Thank
it's
you.
Not that cut and dry. The numbers aren't there. It's
absolutely
math.
No, they have absolutely no knowledge or care to know about the system and how mm-hmm. the system works.
Mm-hmm.
And it's ridiculous.
Yeah. I was watching... Maybe you saw this. It was all over the Twitter. It was some political primary debate in Arizona, and I don't know what office it was for.
For governor.
Was it for governor?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God. The people were, all of them were dumb. The one that cracked me up and also made me cry tears was this older lady is like, she goes, I am pro-life from conception to death. And the moderator goes, so no exceptions for like rape or incest. She's like, well... That's a gray area. I mean, that's a personal choice. Oh, my God. Okay. That's what we're up against here. Like, you don't even know what you say you're standing
yeah,
for.
You don't have a clue on it. It's
no.
It's, oh, my God. Oh,
yeah.
Man. And you need to watch a similar thing was the Wyoming people running against Liz Cheney.
I saw that one? Yeah. She was the beacon of sanity
yeah.
on that stage.
Yeah.
I can't believe I'm saying that about Liz Cheney.
Yeah.
But I totally am, and I totally mean it.
Yeah.
And I'm so impressed with her on the here. And that's a whole nother thing. We're not even talking about the seditious conspiracy
yeah.
that is looming over our former president.
Okay, so just to mention that, the only word I can, it just keeps coming to my mind over and over again, Chris, is... Nonsense. It's all nonsense. So this person, what's her name? Cassidy Hutchinson.
Yeah.
She answers the questions. She's under oath.
Mm-hmm.
She says things like, well, I think the conversation was about this. And then they attack her because she doesn't know exactly what. Did you see that one?
I did. Yeah. The hearsay about him lunging at the driver.
Yeah.
But then what she said was, I was told by somebody
yes.
else. Like, she set it up. She didn't say, I know this happened.
Well, that is going to the hearsay thing. You see that on social media, people, oh, hearsay. That is all a bunch of dummies watching Fox News and thinking that they're watching Judge Joe Brown or Law and Order, and they think they know hearsay. And Sean Hannity says hearsay, so they repeat it.
Oh yeah,
it's. I tell you what it is. It's nonsense. I can't go. And if they say that, they just show what idiots they are.
Yeah.
Of course it's hearsay. It's nothing. It's not a court.
Yeah.
They asked her a question. She answered it.
I know. I know. That, did you watch? It was pretty compelling testimony, I must say.
Yeah. And the other thing I heard about this week, which there's. It sounds too conspiracy, but there are things behind the scenes that why people do things. And so Cassidy Hutchinson has this guy who was Jeff Sessions' main guy as her attorney.
Oh, interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
After the way Jeff Sessions, who's a nut job, was loyal to Trump.
Yeah.
Stabbed in the back.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
It's all interesting to me.
That I didn't realize. I knew she had like a Trump-provided attorney and then switched.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it's, to me, from a purely voyeuristic, purient point of view, it is so compelling. The hearings and all of this, it's slowly unraveling. And I kind of hate how giddy I am that it's a clearer and clearer picture
mm-hmm.
that he was the asshole that I thought he was all along.
Yes. The words I kept hearing were shocking, not surprising.
Yes. There you go.
Hey, we got this text. I think it's Amy.
Mm-hmm.
Good morning again. She's in Facebook penitentiary.
Oh.
Yesterday I got 7 days for saying a joke. I want to whip someone with my laptop on a live stream.
Well,
I'm all for that. I'm all for her having, I believe she has the right and to choose.
It's her choice
to beat someone violently with a laptop. So thanks for listening, Amy.
Yes.
I appreciate that.
You're the constant listener, Amy.
Yeah. Man, I get a lot of good... follow her on Twitter, and she mm-hmm. has some good links. And
she does. I've gotten a lot of good follows by looking at the folks that she's retweeted and whatnot.
Now, Chris, what else is going on? What's going on with Chris? That's what everyone wants to know.
They really do. I mean, you know, the biggest thing from the past week for me, and you're not going to be surprised because you were there.
Yeah, let's talk about it.
You and I were on a television show taping together.
We sure were.
Going to be coming out in, what, about a week and a half or so? So that's exciting. It's the last show, so I know you guys all love it. And it's, I'm not sure exactly where it plays. I think on YouTube.
It's on Televita.
Televita, yes.
I don't know what that is. But
I think it's Spanish, and it's odd because I don't speak a lick.
Of Spanish?
Of Spanish, yeah. But that was fun. So it's our old buddy Elliot Threet, one of the most famous comics to ever come out of Kansas City, and a sharp businessman in his own right as well. And he's got this show, and it's set up like your typical talk show. You know, it's the Kimmel or the Seth Meyers or whatever. And we came out and we went on set. We had an interview. I think it was a good interview.
Do you?
I don't know. It was okay. It's going to be interesting to me to see what they cut out. Because he said they got to get it down to 20 minutes. And I think we went like 28.
Yeah. Now my sound isn't working, Chris.
So nobody can hear us?
No, my little sound effect stuff.
Oh, shoot.
Let's see here.
And I don't want to brag.
Complete denial.
Oh, there's something.
Okay, there we go. Okay.
I don't want to brag on us, but I do believe that Elliot's done a lot of these shows, and he said that we were as easy to talk to as Joel Nichols.
Wow, yeah. Chris.
Yep. That makes me feel good that the two of us combined are as good as one Joel Nichols. I'll take that
there's
every day of the week and twice on Sunday.
Let me tell you something. That's not true. We're not that. No, we're not that good. I mean,
I don't know. I feel like that's what he said. In here my we go.
This is his theme song. I just happen to have the same song.
Nice.
So we were there.
Yep.
We went to the lovely. Sorry, I was distracted there for a little bit.
Oh, that's okay.
We were at the lovely Televita Studios in downtown Kansas. It wasn't downtown, but it was Kansas, beautiful yeah. Kansas City.
Nice studio.
Met the staff.
Mm-hmm.
Got some barbecue sauce.
Yeah, yeah.
So
and got a James lemonade.
Mm-hmm.
Very yes. good. Not so, too tart, not too sweet.
So we're promoting the show, and later we have to give him a clip from this show. Should we do the abortion rants?
I don't know. I'm almost feeling like maybe we should look for something else. But again, it's our choice
yeah.
what we want to give him.
But he was interested in what we do on this podcast and what we do at KCTK, and I basically told him, you know, there's not enough local voices going around. And I know we're talking about a national issue, folks. I know we're not adding anything to the discussion, but we're local people.
We are.
And if we cared anything about local stuff, we would tell you about it. Right. So.
You can't sit still to this music.
Here comes Ellie, and he's coming your way. He's gonna be funny with Joel Nichols. And maybe Dustin Kaufman will be there.
Oh, yeah, Dust has been on. Steve Kramer. It's a veritable who's who of Kansas City almost made it.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
So anyway, we'll let you know when.
Yeah,
that's
we'll let
on,
you know
everyone.
When it's on, and maybe we can post a link. I don't know yeah. how that works in this yeah. gig economy. I'm just throwing out words. I don't even know what they mean.
And you know what? I'm going to say it.
Uh oh.
It's not official, but the people listening to the show are not. They're not listeners.
No.
They're not friends.
No.
They're family. Okay. We'll be joining Televita. We'll be. You'll be seeing Chris and Paul on Televita.
Let's just say they're
either on the late on the last show or something like that, okay?
Let's just say their people and our people might have some back channel stuff going. I don't mm-hmm. know.
It will definitely be back channel.
Gross.
Hey, Chris.
Yeah.
Do you have anything else that you did?
God, no.
Anything at all?
No.
Okay.
No, nothing.
Then let's go to the news quiz. I can't wait to go to it. It's been a as the kids say, it's been a minute.
Yeah, it has. And I'm a little, it'll be interesting to see.
Slate News Quiz, we go to the Slate News Quiz, we ask the questions, we answer the questions. We use it as a way to prompt us to tell you our thoughts on the news. And you're like, awesome.
If it has anything other than Roe v. or the hearings, I don't know if I'm going to know.
Well, here we go then.
Okay.
A January 6th committee hearing held on Tuesday offered bombshell testimony from Cassidy Hutchinson, a former aide to which President Trump staff member.
Oh, Mark Meadows.
That is exactly correct.
He is a guy I would not want to be right now.
Yeah, he sounded a little incompetent.
Yes.
And was he, I think he was the perfect guy for Trump because he never would. It sounded like he would handle the business, but he would never tell Trump the truth
because
he's too afraid of him.
Yes. I'm guessing that kind of goes around.
Mm-hmm.
You got to couch how you say everything to that guy. And well, hey, we're 1-4. I'm excited about this.
Have you ever been to Hutchinson before?
Hutchinson, Kansas?
Yeah.
I think I've driven through. Okay. I call it Hutch.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
But I've not spent any time there.
Okay. Fair enough. Let's go to the second question.
Okay.
Finland and Sweden are officially invited to join NATO after which other member country lifted its objection?
Oh, I think I know this one too. Turkey.
That's right. They were, I say they were turkeys about it. Turkey's interesting because, you know, this rise of tough guy leaders.
Yeah.
NATO's against that, but Turkey has one of those guys.
I know.
Yeah.
It's one of those kind of, you don't want them to be your enemy, and they're probably the least powerful of all the nations, but they're the one making the shot. It's mm-hmm. a weird deal.
You know, this comes as at a good time to it strengthens NATO.
Mm-hmm.
I if you would ask me before, I would have thought Finland and Sweden were a part of NATO.
I thought they were too. I was surprised to hear that. Yeah.
And do they add a lot of military? Might, maybe not, but it shows this, folks, believe it or not, that President Biden is able to bring people together in the world.
Huh. Wow.
Something that helped him a lot. He had two things going for him that helped him a lot. Putin is making everyone against him.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then Trump was such a terrible at it that it's easier to work with Biden.
Yeah.
But he still is getting it done, folks. And that's good. And, you know, inflation is high. Gas is high. It sucks. It's, interest rates are going up. But... there's a war going on in Europe. There hasn't been a war going on in Europe since 1940s.
Yeah.
Folks, I mean, yes.
And it was a big one.
Yes, it's going to hurt our economy when the West is at war.
Yeah.
I know we should care that much when we're in war in Afghanistan and these other things, but this is the Western world, and we're all interrelated in the economy, and of course inflation is going to be high.
Yeah. Yeah,
I don't like it either. By the way, by the way, I don't know if you saw this Thursday, inflation is cooling off a bit.
I did see that,
and it helped interest rates a tremendous amount on Thursday. So, to me, maybe that's a light at the end of the tunnel.
Yeah, I hope so. Hope so.
Now, gas prices are high.
They are high.
Where everyone is, they're calling me, they're texting me, they want to know what does Chris think about getting rid of the gas tax.
I mean, I think it's a nice gesture.
Mm-hmm.
It's something that the president can do. Because people keep saying, well, why don't you do something? Why don't you do something?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Because he's just intentionally, because it's under his control.
Right.
He's just intentionally keeping it high.
Yeah.
It's
like that he's trying to think of something can control.
Yeah.
I'm against it because I don't trust the oil companies. I think he'll jack it up and keep the money. That's what I think.
Yeah.
But you should watch the Wyoming Republican. They don't like Ukraine. Ukraine's corrupt.
Oh, yes. God.
And I don't know. It's somehow we have not only right-wing talking points on Fox News and others, we have Russian propaganda being presented on all these outlets.
Yeah.
What the heck, man?
I don't know. I don't know.
I asked you a question, Chris. What the heck? And I want an answer.
Yeah. It's just scary to me. It's just really scary. Yeah.
Okay.
And this whole war could get worse. Yes. I read a thing last night. This guy who's a geopolitical analyst thinks Putin's move now is to starve Europe because they rely on grain from Ukraine so much. And so they have blockaded. They can't get any ships out to supply grain to the rest of Europe.
Mm.
So that's what this guy thinks his next move is going to be, to starve Europe to turn sentiment against Ukraine.
We're in a battle, guys.
Yeah.
We're in a battle. You know, I like to say war. What is it good for?
Absolutely nothing.
Thank you. Say it again.
All right.
Okay, next question. Which accounting firm agreed to pay $100 million fine to the Securities and Exchange Commission after some of its auditors cheated on ethics exams?
I don't know.
I don't know this. See, I've never heard this one.
Yeah. I want to say PricewaterhouseCoopers, but I don't know. No.
Oh, it was Ernst & Young. Wait, isn't Ernst & Young the two old guys that did the wine coolers?
No, they were the Muppets that set up and made fun of them on the stage.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
And they're the ones, they were always at the show. They didn't do their ethics exam.
Right. Yeah. Yep. Yeah.
The irony, the largest fine ever imposed on an auditing firm.
That is ironic.
Yes.
Don't you think?
Damn it.
Stupid.
Okay, we didn't get that right, but we'll move on. Michigan Supreme Court unanimously overturned the state's use of judge serving as a one-person grand jury to indict former Governor Rick Snyder in a criminal case over contamination water in which city?
It's got to be Flint, right?
I would think Flint. Yeah, that's right. I don't know anything about this story at all.
I don't either, but we were in like Flint on that answer.
City managers used water from the Flint River to save money, insisting it didn't need to be treated to reduce its corrosive qualities because of the leaching of lead from old pipes. So.
Inhumane.
Yeah, terrible.
Oh, God, yeah.
Okay.
But at least we got the question right. Yeah. So
right. So we're now 3-1, and will we get 4?
We'll see.
Giselle Maxwell, associate of sex crime Jeffrey Epstein, was sentenced this week to how many years in prison for sex trafficking charges?
It's 20.
20 years. 20 years. Yeah. That's correct. Have you followed that very much?
No, I haven't.
I haven't either.
Yeah. I did see a funny joke. You know Blair Erskine on
yes.
Twitter?
Uh-huh.
So she wrote a joke that Chelsea Handler told when she was doing Kimmel's show this week.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, Ghislaine, mm-hmm. I think I'm saying her name wrong, but I like saying Ghislaine.
Yeah.
Got 20 years.
Uh-huh.
R. Kelly got 30 years.
Uh-huh.
So her joke that Chelsea Handler told was, when R. Kelly was told had received a sentence of 30 years, he asked the judge if he could get a younger sentence.
It's pretty funny.
Get it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so good and so great. And, I'm glad both those people are going to be in jail.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's been a while. It's been a while since both of these things happened. But they say the justice system moves very slow.
Mm-hmm.
But
the wheels of justice turn slowly.
But effectively or something
so
like
there's
that?
There's another part to that colloquialism that I don't remember right now.
There's also another saying. It's time for us to take a break, get some more coffee.
Oh, good call.
And we'll be back with, the show that we do. We have some big entertainment news to get to, so excited about that. But we'll be right back with more Past Week Next Week with Chris and Paul.
Yay!
At the past 7 days, so you don't have to. You could join in on the experiment by calling or texting us at 913-735-0060.
We've been told that perfect mornings exist for the lucky few, that morning people own the waking hours. But the truth is, mornings belong to all of us. Your mornings are what you make of them. Takes is saying yes. Starbucks morning yes.
Look for Starbucks coffee in a grocery store near you, then sit back and enjoy the exceptional taste of Starbucks at home.
Hi, this is Chick Lissagoose from Counterclockwise KC. Listen to our program each and every Saturday and Sunday at 7 p.m. right here on KCTK Radio. Personality driven radio.
Hi guys, it's your old friend Paul from KCTK Radio, reminding you again to download the KCTK Radio app. You're listening and you're going, I don't need the app, but you do need the app. Here's why. It's free, okay? You already got Candy Crush, all kinds of jackleg apps on your phone.
It's free. It's free.
Yeah,
it's
just free. Get it for free. And then if you ever want to participate live sometime, you can put the notification on there. Also, you always can get the podcast on there as soon as they come out. So it's a fun thing to do. I'm asking you. I'm pleading with you. Please. You're going to have fun. I've noticed something about you. You need to relax a little bit. You know, you need to kind of chill out.
Get away from TikTok.
Yeah, get away from TikTok for a little bit and listen to the KCTK Radio app. It's free. It will get into your brain and it will never leave you. So join us on the KCTK Radio app and have fun for once in your life. Do it the KCTK podcast way.
This is Tracy from Tracy's Tips and Dips. Listen to the show every weekday at 11:30 a.m. and our live show Wednesday evening at 7 p.m. right here on KCTK Radio, personality-driven radio.
Chris, you were just asking me off the air. You said, what are you holding in your hand?
Yeah, I was concerned. Ew.
Well, I'm holding a bottle of James Lemonade.
Oh, God. That looks good.
And that's who we're promoting today.
Mm-hmm.
James Lemonade is... If those of you on Facebook, you're looking at it and you go, there's nothing in that bottle.
Yeah, what gives?
Because let me tell you something. This is so delicious.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think you'll see a bottle full when I'm around. Because I'm going to drink it.
Because you're just going to drink it.
Because it's so delicious.
Yeah.
Now,
yeah.
You know the story about James and his lemons and his aid.
And his AIDS.
Can you tell the folks about how wonderful this stuff
yeah,
is?
Yeah, so it's James, and I don't know all the specifics. I probably should have prepped, but...
Why would you start?
Yeah, well, okay, good point. He's a local guy, and he started this business in the urban core of Kansas City, and you're seeing James's lemonade, and then he's got like a... either a strawberry or a raspberry lemonade, or maybe it's a fruit punch. It's a red drink. And you'll see that places too. But he's investing a lot of the money that he's making back into the community and making a difference in Kansas City. So for God's sake, support it.
And it's really good too.
It is so good.
We had a very in-depth conversation about this.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's too sweet.
Yeah,
sometimes it's too tart.
When lemonade's good, it's good. But you can mess up lemonade pretty easy. Yeah.
Well, James Anderson, he's got his original recipe. It's been around since 1998. That was the last century, I think.
That was, yeah.
And so it's proven over time. It's delicious. It's fun to hold the bottle.
Ew.
And so check out, it's over at jameslemonade.com. Mm. I think, I don't know, I shouldn't say that. Just Google James Lemonade, and maybe throw in a KC.
You'll
find
good call.
You'll find James Anderson's original recipe, and we love it. We love it so very much. Where can you get this? Do you know?
I think you can find it at your local Price Choppers. You can get it at the Hy-Vee's, and then you're seeing it more and more in restaurants around town. I was at the Filling Station yesterday,
coffee shop,
and they had James Lemonade in their little cooler.
So get yourself some James Lemonade, and of course, tell them Gilly sent you. It doesn't seem to be the same with the Gilly, does it?
What do you mean?
Well, we did the poop bags.
The poop bags was a more direct connection.
I mean, did I need the poop bag today?
You could have used it, yeah.
But they're not our sponsor anymore. So.
Yeah, so now you just have dog shit all over your living room.
Right.
But you can't pick it up. Because they're no longer our sponsor.
Yeah.
So,
Charmin.
What are you going to do?
Charmin's our new sponsor.
Poor Gilly.
But she's a true dear.
I was about to say that would suck to just have poop come out of your butt when you're unaware.
Mm-hmm.
But I know that it sucks because it's happened to me on more than one occasion.
Recording in progress.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Hey, let's get to the showbiz news. This is where Past Week, Next Week talks about the latest in showbiz. It also is one of those things where the news depresses me, but the pop culture news makes me want to end my life. Chris?
Hey, Paul, let's see if we can get you there. Brian Austin Green and Sharna Burgess welcome their first baby.
Oh, their first baby.
Actor Brian Austin Green and professional dancer Sharna Burgess have welcomed their first child together. The couple announced the birth of their son, Zane, in an identical post shared on their Instagram accounts, which showed their newborn holding Green's finger.
Oh.
Hope he didn't pull it. Brian Austin Green, what is he like 58 now?
Yeah.
He's older, right? Mm-hmm. He's like our age, at least.
Yeah, he's older than us, I think.
And he's having his first kid. I feel for him.
No,
His first
kid with this chick.
With her.
Yeah, he was
with
Megan Fox for a while.
See, I didn't even know that. Yeah. I need to keep up on pop culture.
Well, you
news.
Know what you need to do is listen to this segment on Past Week Next Week.
It's the only show I need for my pop culture
yeah.
news. All right, Paul.
Back to me, Chris.
Sure.
Chanel Haynes says Rolling Stone's gig cost her Tina musical job. Actress singer Chanel Haynes says she was fired as the lead of the West End production of Tina after she performed with the Rolling Stones in Italy. Haynes, who for the past few months have been portraying the legendary Tina Turner in the musical based on her life, told Rolling Stones magazine, which is weird because it's Rolling Stones magazine and Rolling Stones the group.
Right.
It's getting
hard
me very
yeah,
confused.
Yeah.
That she was canned after agreeing to perform Gimme Shelter with the band. Guess what? There's something more to it.
There's got to be something more to this.
Because you would want them to do it. She was probably gone or something.
And let me say this, too, and this just shows how unhip I am. The headline, Chanel Haynes.
Yeah.
When I glanced at it, I thought it said, oh, Cheryl Hines. Okay, I actually know one of the stars we're talking about.
Yeah.
I don't. It's no. not Cheryl Hines, Paul. It's Chanel Haynes. I don't even know who she is.
Okay, so you have a really... This is... Let's say you have a really good job, okay?
Okay.
You do. But you get to be on stage with the Rolling Stones.
Yeah, how cool is that?
It may be worth it.
It might be. Maybe she'll get... There's got to be some other musical she could do, right?
Yeah.
Isn't there some other woman?
I think they're doing Usher, maybe.
The Usher musical?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe she could get that one. Yeah.
What's the name of the guy that did... Orange Juice Jones. I know they're doing that one. That guy. So they're doing a lot of, big.
Yeah. Well, that's sad. But who knows? Maybe this next story will bring us back up.
I'm sure it will.
Okay.
Back to you, Chris.
Oh, thanks, Paul. Cameron Diaz is coming out of retirement thanks to Jamie Foxx.
Yeah.
After an 8-year hiatus. I didn't know she'd not been in anything for 8 years.
Yeah.
Where does time go? Cameron Diaz is making movies again.
Yeah.
Diaz, who officially confirmed her retirement from Hollywood in 2018, is set to star in the new Netflix film Back in Action alongside Jamie Foxx. The two previously starred together in 2014's Annie, Diaz's last feature film appearance.
Wow.
I had no idea.
I'm glad they're back together. When I think of a dramatic and... musical couple, I think Jamie Foxx and Cameron Diaz.
Yeah, I didn't even know they were an Annie together. What planet do I live on?
I don't know.
Yeah,
Chris.
I'm unaware.
The Chris bubble.
Well, let's see if I can learn something in this next story, Paul.
Thanks, Chris. You know, Lizzo called Beyonce her North Star during her carpool karaoke appearance.
Hmm.
This is story that made me want to say, I want to end it all. I can't live in this world anymore.
Oh, God, I can't wait to hear this.
The Beehive has yet another celebrity among its ranks, Lizzo. In a Monday appearance in the Late Late Show with James Corden, the Good as Hell singer called Beyonce her North Star during a carpool karaoke segment. Lizzo said she named her flute Sasha Flute, a play on Beyonce's alter ego, Sasha Fierce. She told Corden about the influence the icon, whom she has never met, has always had on her. See, so here's the thing.
Yeah.
I pull a story from CNN.
Uh-huh.
CNN pulls a story because they're watching the TV. Okay. Then they're
right.
talking about other celebrities and a flute. This is where we are in the world, folks. This is what we're called hot celebrity talk.
It's crazy that we're going from news stories straight out of... Gilead from The Handmaid's Tale.
Yeah.
And then we go to these just complete drivel.
Yes, complete drivel.
Yeah.
So she tells a guy in a car that she likes another celebrity. They tape it. It's on the TV. Then someone's seen it and watches it, makes it a report.
Uh-huh.
Then Paul pulls it, and we talk about it. Then we show a segment. And it's on Televita. And all of the good viewers of Televita are going, what?
and round we go.
Back to you, Chris.
Hey, thanks, Paul. True Detective Season 4 to star Kylie, Reese, and Jodie Foster.
I've heard of her.
True Detective Night Country will star Kylie Reese with the previously announced casting of Jodie Foster. It will be HBO's fourth season of the series. Writer, director, showrunner Issa Lopez will spearhead the latest season. The plot will focus on six men, go on, that operate... the Sassel Arctic Research Station in Ennis, Alaska, or maybe it's Ennis, I'm not sure, who vanish without a trace. The upcoming season will be filmed in Iceland.
It's Ennis. Gee, gee, gee. Get it?
I don't.
Do you remember Ennis? He was on the Dukes of Hazzard.
Yes, yes. Oh, my God. Ennis.
Ennis.
Yeah.
And then Ennis went to L.A. and became a cop.
Yeah, he got his own show.
It was awesome.
Yeah. Ennis, you metal muffin mouth. Remember Roscoe would always get pissed at Yeah. It's all coming back to me now.
You ratting,
you two-timing, no good, cock-sucking mother...
Recording stopped.
That's going to be the end of the... That's going to be the end of the segment that we get to tell Vina.
Oh, that's perfect. That is perfect. Let me say this. Okay. For reals, though. I watched... True Detective.
Did you say cocksucking on Televita?
I don't know. I guess Joseph can pull it out in post if he has
the cocksucker can pull it. Wow. You can't pull it out in post anymore. That's Roe v. Wade said you can't even do that anymore.
I don't even get to choose what to pull out in post.
Mm-mm.
Oh my God.
He gets to decide what he pulls out in post.
Yes, he does.
In post.
God. See.
Okay, you were saying.
And now you do have to pull out a lot more.
Yeah.
Because post is gone.
Right.
Anyway, so I watched True Detective Season 1 and loved it.
Okay.
That was the Woody Harrelson.
Matthew McConaughey.
Thank you, Matthew McConaughey. Mm-hmm. Tried the others and just couldn't get into them. Jodie Foster. I'm intrigued. Yeah. I'm going to want to try this out, I think.
Yeah. Hot take. Jodie Foster's a good actress.
She's really good.
Yeah.
Yeah. And her being in True Detective takes me right back to Silence of the Lambs because I feel like the eerie, atmospheric thing is very similar. So,
do you feel like she should have not let Hannibal Lecter get away at the end of that movie?
Yeah, I feel like that was maybe a miss on her part.
Well, I hope she does better this time.
Yeah, well, we can hope.
And Chris, this is something that everyone's been wanting to know about.
Oh, God, okay.
And this is another story that just try to keep up with this, okay? Mm-hmm. Dakota Johnson on the mayhem of filming 50 Shades. Okay, that's the headline.
Okay, gotcha.
Since 2015, she's been a globally known actor, but now says the franchise she signed up for was not the one that was made. I'm a sexual person, and I'm interested in something I want to know so much about. Johnson tells Vanity Fair in a new cover story. That's why I did those big naked movies. I signed up to do a very different version of the film we ended up making. Johnson adds that the studio and directors were part of the problem, and that the author of Fifty Shades books, E.L. James, also became a problem on the set.
Wait, there's so much I don't understand about this.
Okay, let's try to unpack this. Number one, she never says what the problem was.
Right, yeah. What was the problem?
I'm going to tell you what the problem was, okay?
Uh-huh.
This is a young actress who thought she's going to be in these movies, and the movies end up sucking, okay?
Oh.
They stink. And now she's older, and she's like, well, it wasn't my problem. It was a mess. And it's like, you made a bad movie. Big deal, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you can't be like us. Every podcast we do is right on.
Gold, Jerry, gold.
It's just right gold, right? But sometimes you make some bad movies when you're young.
I don't understand this quote from her.
It's big naked.
I'm a sexual person, and when I'm interested in something, I want to know so much about it.
Yeah, so that movie's about their sexual. I'm going to say it that way from now on. Their sexual relationship. And so she had to be naked. That was the book. Everyone read the book.
Right.
Everyone loved it so very much.
I didn't.
Well, you didn't read it, did you?
Well, my wife read me excerpts.
Yeah.
They were ridiculous.
They were completely you know what's as ridiculous as those segments in those books?
Yeah.
Porno that men watch. You know what I mean?
Right.
So it's just, you know, whatever, I say float your boat, whatever gets you going. And it is clearly a woman's.
Well, whose choice is it though?
Well, we know now it has to be a man's choice.
Okay. Gotcha. You know? Good.
Right. And, so anyway, Dakota, stop it.
I don't know
why you were hired for that movie in the first place.
Yeah, I don't get it.
And also, let me just say the naked scenes, I wouldn't be bragging so much.
Yeah. I didn't see the movies. I didn't know.
I fast forward through the naked scenes. I wasn't that impressed.
Wow, that says a lot.
I go over to TikTok and see something better than that. none of this will be on television.
Okay, yeah. Lordy, let's hope.
Well, Chris, we've been talking for quite a bit.
We have.
We usually have a special feature, but the special feature that we've talked about is, you know, we've gone through the news and said that. And, you know, let's just get right into getting people prepared for the next week coming up.
Yeah, let's do that. This is probably, for a lot of people, their favorite part of the show, I would guess.
Yeah. Someone is watching us on Facebook. They can't comment or react because they're in a Facebook penitentiary. I want to know more about that next time.
Yeah.
Okay. And, you know, we've kind of been, you know, stressed out a little bit about the news, where everything's going. And, you know, who doesn't seem like he gives a shit about that is the texter. He's usually there to settle us down, make us feel better about ourselves. But in this time of this trials and tribulations that we're going through, where's he?
Not here.
Gone.
He ain't here.
So let's get into headlines and predictions.
All right. And folks, this is where we take actual news stories ripped from the headlines, and we write our own hilarious spin on it. It's almost like a weekend update from SNL, if you will. So here we go, guys.
Also, they work at their jokes. Okay.
Yeah, you brought up a very good point. We were talking. This isn't for us so much an exercise in joke writing as it's an exercise in improv, because none of us puts any time. Neither one of us puts any time.
No, and we
or develops or thinks about.
And we get the story, and we have to make our comment or our joke about that story.
That one. Yeah.
So we're much more talented than Colin Jost and Michael Che.
Way more talented. Yeah. So, and just to prove
it. Let me have... I gave you the wrong one with my punchlines.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That was close.
That was close.
Okay.
Okay, here we go, folks. The Supreme Court limited the Environmental Protection Agency's authority to use the Clean Air Act to regulate greenhouse gas emissions, marking a major setback for the Biden administration's push to replace coal-burning plants with cleaner energy sources to mitigate climate change. That was an inside joke from a wife. Capping carbon dioxide emissions to transition away from coal power may be a sensible solution to the crisis of the day, but it's up to Congress, not the EPA, to make a decision of such magnitude, Chief Justice John Roberts wrote in the decision. Yes, you heard that correctly, folks. The future viability of our entire planet is dependent upon Congress's decision-making ability. Paul? It's not a joke, really.
No, it's sad.
Yeah.
How do you say the justice's first name?
Katanji, I believe.
Katanji Brown Jackson took the judicial oath of office and became the first black woman to serve on the Supreme Court. Justice Jackson, 51, was sworn in as Justice Steve Breyer, 83, officially retired at the end of the court's term. Jackson was confirmed earlier this year to replace Breyer when he stepped down as the 116th justice and just the sixth woman to serve on the high court. Jackson's arrival on the court doesn't change its ideological makeup, leaving the conservative majority at 6-3. Because of the recent rulings of the Supreme Court, Jackson said, "I know this job is supposed to be for life, but I may not want to work with all these idiots very long." Chris?
Thanks, Paul. The Supreme Court...
I liked you just kind of... He's trying...
No, I'm going along.
I appreciate
along.
It. Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
It's not great, but you saw my effort.
It was relevant. It was timely. It fit in. It made sense.
Yeah. It just wasn't funny.
It checked every box except funny. Speaking of, the Supreme Court ruled that President Biden can end former President Donald Trump's controversial Remain in Mexico immigration policy. The policy requires some non-Mexican citizens detained at the southern U.S. border to return to Mexico to await the outcome of their applications for asylum. Texas and Missouri, challenged Biden's efforts to lift the policy, and lower courts blocked Biden from reversing it. But the Supreme Court ruled 5-4 that Biden had the authority to wind down the program. In a dissenting opinion, Justice Clarence Thomas wrote that while Biden can get rid of the Remain in Mexico program, he thinks the court should relook at previous cases and determine if Biden can be forced to bring back Just Say No and be compelled to implement a Pray Away the Gay policy. Paul?
He probably did.
I know. It's supposed to be ludicrous, but I don't know if it's ludicrous enough.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, Chris, thanks. President Biden said that he would back suspending the Senate's filibuster rule if necessary to pass a federal law protecting the abortion rights following the Supreme Court's decision overturning Roe v. Wade. Under the filibuster rule, most bills must clear a 60-vote threshold to reach a final vote. With the Senate split 50-50, Democrats need the entire caucus and 10 Republicans to meet the bar. Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell criticized Biden, accusing him of undermining equal justice and the rule of law, and further said that this angered him because it was the Republicans' job to undermine equal justice and the rule of law, not Democrats. Chris?
That fucking guy. Seriously.
Yeah.
He's going to come in and talk about undermining the rule of law.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to do that after he completely blocked a president from being able to appoint a Supreme Court judge. And oh my God. He is the most shameless, duplicitous. That guy, he's as evil as Donald Trump, but he's smart, too, which is, oh, wow.
Pretty handsome fella, too.
He is good looking.
Back to you, Chris.
Yeah. Love to suck on his gobbler.
Oh, no.
That's the thing on his throat. I just want to make that clear.
Okay.
Yes. I really don't want to suck it.
Okay.
The fire department of South Korea is warning cat owners to be especially careful in the kitchen. More than 100 house fires in the city between January 2019 and November 2021 were attributed to cats accidentally turning on electric stoves.
Oh, no.
If an electric stove has touch-sensitive buttons, a cat can accidentally switch it on by jumping up and hitting the controls with their paws. Everyone knows, of course, that those fires weren't accidents, but if the cats find out we're onto them, we're all goners. Paul?
Thanks, Chris.
Sure.
And finally, your Amazon Alexa, see how beeped up when I said that?
Oh, it sure did.
Your Amazon Alexa may soon be able to replicate real human voices. The update on Alexa's system would allow the virtual assistant to mimic the voice of any person based on less than a minute of a recording. In a demonstration, the company played a video showing a young boy asking, "Alexa, can Grandma finish reading me The Wizard of Oz?" Alexa acknowledges the request and switches to a voice mimicking the child's grandmother who has passed away to read the book. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Now Tucker Carlson can have his dream of listening to Mein Kampf read directly by Hitler himself.
Oh, nice. Nice. Yes. Would you want to hear a dead relative's voice in your Alexa? I think it would bother me.
Not at all.
I don't think I'd want. Yeah.
No, but I think it would be kind of cool if you could. I don't know. Do they have any? There's probably not enough audio of Mark Twain.
Oh, yeah.
But have Mark Twain reading
Huckleberry Finn.
Yes, or something like that.
Here's what I think is going to happen.
That'd be kind of neat.
I think you're going to see a horror movie come out where somebody's kid dies, and they put their voice into their Alexa, and then they hear their kid's voice to be comforting, but then the kid starts talking to them about stuff.
And this is a great movie idea. Will you write a letter to Hollywood right now?
And you tell know what? Them? I will. Dear Hollywood, I'm just a 54-year-old boy in Independence, Missouri, but I have an idea for a movie.
Get Hollywood on the line.
Don't you think that's going to happen?
Yes.
That is going to be a movie, and then they find out their kid, their disembodied consciousness is in the internet somewhere, and they've got to find out how to bring him back. And
I just thought of something terrible. If this works, what happens to your career as a voiceover guy for books?
Dude, it's done.
Is it?
Did you know I'm on this website, and I got like $11.75 from them last month.
Bragger.
Where I read 30 minutes of nonsense words.
Yes.
And then they turned it into a voice that you can buy online to use for your voiceover
stuff. The nonsense, was it from this podcast?
Believe it or not, it was more nonsensical than this podcast. Yeah.
So this is this Alexa is really putting you out of business.
Yeah. I mean, not that I had a lot of business going on anyway.
I'm excited because I wrote this book.
Mm-hmm.
You may know it. It's called Your Elected Representative.
It's a very funny book.
Thank
it's really
you.
Good.
And I haven't really promoted or done anything and tried to. But some people have read it. They think it's funny. But yeah. I have a lot of people go, when are you doing the voiceover?
Yeah.
The audiobook
right.
of it. And, I have the studio. I could do it. I've done 3 chapters. But I don't like working.
Oh.
And it seems like work to me.
Oh, yeah.
So now if I could pass away, if someone could mimic my voice, then the book will finally be read.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't even think about that. When I finish my book, I could potentially just buy my voice
yes.
from the
yes.
AI company and uh-huh. not have to read it
right.
at all.
And then you could pay. How much does it cost to buy your voice?
I don't even know.
So let's say you drop $50.
Yeah.
You're getting 11 back.
I'm getting 11 bucks back out of the deal.
Right.
I'm cutting out the middleman.
Right.
Well, not really, but.
Yeah.
Yeah. So,
but then you don't have to read your book because who wants to read your book?
Yeah.
You don't want to.
I don't want to. God, I'm having a hard enough time writing it.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's, that's creepy to me.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah. I think especially a passed away,
mm-hmm.
that would be weird. But, Dear Hollywood, you'll be seeing us on, a direct line to Hollywood.
Yeah.
Is either you pick up the red phone or you are on Televita. And Hollywood will become knocking.
You know what? Maybe we go ahead and write and produce this movie ourselves, and we become, the younger next version of Matt Damon and Ben Affleck.
Yeah. They are a couple years older than us, so we are younger. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. It's an idea.
Yeah.
That's all I'm saying.
I'm going to have to be the Ben because I'm taller, and I think he did less of the work.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so do you remember, it is about not wanting to do work. You came up with the idea for a skit of the fat gap.
Yes.
And then what? 2 years later, you saw that exact skit on Saturday Night Live.
Yeah.
I think there's this like actual stream of consciousness and there's ideas floating in it. And if you grab one and you do something with it, it becomes yours. But if you don't do anything, it floats on down the stream and somebody else grabs it.
I feel like there's often over in 30 Rock, there's like... Mr. Lauren, what's his last name?
Michaels.
Lauren Michaels. I'm busy right now. I'm busy. And he's listening.
To. It's the past week, next week, and everything like that. Yay.
And he's writing down these ideas and stuff.
Yeah.
And then he has to quickly turn it off.
So it might not
and they
be.
Go, and they go, what's that app on your phone? That looks like a pug to me. He goes, no. It's a variety.
Yeah. That's not a pug. That's a naked woman.
Yeah.
Why don't you mind your own business?
That's a naked young man. So a lot of the ideas they get from us.
God. Yeah, goodness. They do. They stay. Here I thought it was some mystical thing, and it's just Lorne Michaels listening to this program.
Yes. Right. Yeah.
It's good stuff.
Yeah.
It's good stuff.
Chris, what do you got going on for the next week?
Yeah, well, so it's, holiday tomorrow. It's the 4th mm-hmm. of July. So that's kind of exciting. Now, before I get to celebrating the 4th of July today, I'm moving my wife to...
She's had it with you, I guess.
She's moving out. She's actually moving her location where she performs her work. So we're moving her into a studio suite today. As soon as I leave here, I'm going to go hang curtains and shelves and stuff. And then it's just regular work for me. I don't got a whole lot going on in my life, Paul.
Well, I'm hitting the pool today and tomorrow.
Oh, nice.
Hopefully, nice. All your work will be done. You're welcome to join us.
Yeah, hoping to stop by tomorrow.
KCTK pool. And enjoy yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And then I took the day off on Tuesday.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Good for you.
Nothing to do, but just kind of...
Yeah. Recover.
Recover, yeah.
Yeah. I that's nice. I wish I could.
Because Friday we had a great time. We went to King G, West Side Local, the Rieger booze place.
Oh, down by Knuckleheads?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Great time, great friends.
Oh,
good times.
Fun.
Then last night went to the Kenny G concert. No.
Oh, Kenny G sold out Arrowhead,
yeah.
Huh?
Kenny Chesney.
Oh, wow. Oh, and, yeah.
You know, had some cocktails.
You've
stuff.
Had a fun weekend.
Yeah, and it's not over yet.
Wow.
Oh, it's not over. The Always most fun so. Is this, of course.
Well, yeah.
So, it's going to be fun. You'll hear all about it next week.
Can't wait.
And that's it. That's basically what is going on. And I don't know. Anything else we need to add before we close the show?
God, I hope not.
Really?
I'm bored. No.
Okay, well, let's close the show then.
Okay. Yeah, let's do it. Hey, folks, we kind of close it the same way we open it, right? Or I'm assuming we do.
Yeah.
It's hard to tell. Oh, boy, I need to jiggle my cord a little bit again.
There we go.
Well, it's not. I think it's a little better. Okay, so you're playing a song here.
Yeah. So, aren't you supposed to say something?
Oh, you want me to read this?
Uh-huh.
See, I don't even know what I'm doing anymore. Hey, everybody, thanks for listening to Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul. You guys love the program, so why don't you rate and review it on your favorite podcast distributor already? We'd love to hear from you, and you can contact us at 913-735-0060 or at pastweeknextweek@gmail.com. And join the Past Week, Next Week Facebook page. Also, make sure you listen to all the great programs on KCTK Radio. Plus, support all of our sponsors, including James Lemonade. On behalf of Paul, I'm Chris saying goodbye.
And on behalf of Chris, we're going to end in the show and get you ready for next week with... That's right.
This is
Neil Diamond's America.
Such a pretty song.
It's a great song. It's a very patriotic. If you listen to the words and the emotions of it, it's about people coming to America searching for freedom.
Yeah.
People used to do that.
Wait. It's not about people trying to keep others out from America and keep all the freedom for themselves and away from others?
Yeah. And that's... You know, there's a lot of criticism of our country and things we've done bad in the past, but this all makes me think about the beacon of freedom it should be and how we should really try to continually live up to the words of the Declaration of Independence. It's like a nonstop, it's a never-ending battle, as Superman would call it, but it feels like people have given up.
Yes.
You know?
Yeah, it does. And you see the despair on the social medias and stuff. And folks said, just thrown in the towel, game over. But we've been the leader of the free world for a long time now. There's something good.
But we haven't for that long. In the scheme of history, we haven't done it that long. You know what I mean?
We're the most recent power that's...
Mm-hmm.
That's been the number one in the world. There's something good in what we've attempted to do.
Our country should be about and was about principles and values. Freedom, self-expression, freedom of speech. All this ideas that band us together, that we agree on these freedoms. That's why we're American, not because we all have the same religion or the same ethnic background.
Yes.
And that's what's so amazing about our country. It's never happened in the history it ever did.
Yeah.
It never had happened.
You know what?
And we get to live through this time, and we're also damn lazy. We just forget about it.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. And maybe in the grand scheme of things for our country, this is good. We had a black man elected president.
Uh-huh.
And it's brought to the surface all this ugliness.
Yes.
All this ugliness that was hidden, I guess, that I wasn't aware of. It's out, and now we're having to face it and deal with it.
But we got to grow. We got to just keep growing.
Well, that's it. You know? That's it. This is going to be our chance to either overcome and be better and do better, or, I don't know, or we regress. And somebody else steps up and does better.
And I know how exciting it is to say how terrible the Founding Fathers were. But they were people of their time, and they had the things that they pursued.
Right.
And if you even read Jefferson, he was like, every 20 years you should go through a thing and change it.
Yeah.
So what's so wrong with getting rid of the filibuster? What's so wrong with
Getting
rid of the Electoral College? We've gone past it. And the only reason is because these people in the minority can't control the government if we do that.
Yes. Problem is, the people in the minority, I'm generalizing here,
minority of views, right?
Yeah. Are Bible literalists.
Uh-huh.
Which, that whole thing is hypocritical.
It's nonsense.
Because every person that reads it has a different interpretation of what it literally means. But they look at the Constitution and our founding articles the same way. And they're not infallible.
Yes.
They're not!
Thank you, Chris. Have a great holiday, everybody.
This has been a KCTK production, produced by Paul Lavone. If you want more information about this content, then you have some real weirdness going on. You can always check out KCTK Radio on Facebook. Listen to live programs at kctkradio.com. Yes, and that is on the World Wide Web. Thank you.